Hello, YouTubers. Welcome to another episode of Atomic Maniac Productions. This is me, Maniac. So, what I'm going to be doing here today is I'm going to be doing a review over the standard loot baton that you unlock at the beginning of the game. What I was going to start off with, actually, this was going to be a stub notes review, but I wasn't having much luck with it, so I decided to switch over to the police baton. I realized in the last video, the audio was like really loud and not that good. I don't know why. It may just be the sound room that makes it loud. I will try and fix it today and like edit some of the things. And I do have speech permit, so that can make it a little bit harder for you to understand me, especially with bad audio. So I will be trying to do a couple things to fix that. And hopefully it helps. It may not, but hopefully it does. So, yeah. So we got the Sand Police Baton. I believe it does 75 damage. Like, one hit up close, like from the front, I believe it only does 75 damage, because you can see right there, I believe that says 75. So, two swipes from the front, but if you go from the side or from the back, it will be an instant takedown on the guy. So, that's something to think about. Now, I kind of like the baton a little bit more than the knife. The knife, it's probably better if you're going up against multiple enemies from behind. Up front, it doesn't matter, because both of them just kind of do like the slicing motion, I guess you could say. So, from up front, it doesn't matter because they're both going to do about the same. But from behind, let's say you have one guy, he's on his back, you're taking him out, and then his buddy's right next to him, so you have to go through that long animation, take him down, his buddy could realize what's going on and take you out, and that's where the knife comes a little bit handy because it does do the animation faster. So you have, I guess you could say, Red Sands again taken out. But I like the baton because you get the non-lethal bonus and the interrogation bonus. And the interrogation thing does help your team see enemies on the main map. So that's an added plus. And here's where the glitch starts. Right there. I have no idea how to activate it. I have no idea why it happens. I've never been able to redo it, besides like, I was able to do it one more time on this map during this video. I have no idea why. I'm not sure if it's still in the game. I have not played Hardline in a while. These videos that I'm editing right now, I've had them on my PlayStation for a couple months, and I'm just now getting to edit them, because me and my friends were trying to get everything set for our gaming thing, and we got busy with stuff, so. But yeah, that's the glitch. Like, I have no idea why it's there, how to activate it. It's I figured it'd be a fun little thing to add in to the video to make it a little better. And there it is again. See, this is the only map I was able to do it on. I didn't actively try to go and do it again. It just kind of happened. I figured it was going to be like a one-time thing, but I don't know, you may be able to get it somehow. I don't know, I haven't really seen anything else with it, so. That'll be it for today's video. I'll see you all later.